One of the good friends of mine that I worked with on Hogan's Heroes for 6 years was Dickie Dawson, the fine Englishman, who is presently on the Laugh-In show. And Dickie has some reminiscence about his school days, way back in England, right,
Dick? Well, the school of England only went for 2 years because of the war, you know. All of schools closed in England during the war.
What do you mean you only went for 2 years?
I went from the age of 11 and a half to 13 and a half.
Well, what did you do before then?
Well, of course, I went out with a lot of girls. No, we were evacuated, and my brother and I...
Well, you went to school as a kid.
We would have gone to school.
Well, don't you start at 6 years of age in England?
Right, yeah, but the war came, we were evacuated. My brother and I were sent to a place where they beat us up and were horrible to us, and we came back, and they sent us away again to another home.
Wait a minute. Well, where was this place that they beat you up?
Well, yeah, all the kids got taken into different families, you know. And we just happened to be moved in with Ray Milland standing in the last weekend. they were lovely. And they'd get drunk at night and hit us. So we left. Then we got sent to another...
And you were how old then?
Well, my brother was 5 years old. I was seven. And my brother was 12, so he was the one that got us.
So the only education then was how to beat somebody up.
Well, how to avoid being beaten up by jumping on a train.
I see.
But now, the school, when we did go, was we had a teacher called Mr. Berry, who I believe during the war worked in a various camp. He had his initials either for Sylvia Sidney or something tattooed under his arm. He hated me. And we had school lunches. The first school lunch came. I never ate anything green. Right? Now, the meat was green. I wouldn't eat it. No green vegetables at all.
Yeah.
And he walks down the aisle, and they put the first meal there, and I was dreading it. And it was cabbage and some other garbage and everything. So I managed to force down the meat and the potatoes. Couldn't touch the cabbage. And he came by, and he said, "Clean your plate." I said, "I can't eat it, Mr. Barrett." And he sprinkled some salt and pepper, and he took a paper napkin and shoved it into my throat. Really vicious. He was a horrible man. And he said, "Eat that cabbage. Clean your plate.
Yeah.
There are people starving in Europe."
Yeah, and you said what?
And I said, "Name two."
This is Bob Crane with our Back to School special, and just a moment ago talking to Dickie Dawson about reminiscences, and kind of sad reminiscences when you think about it. His school days were interrupted by the war. We here in America, of course, the war was on when I was in school, too. In fact, that was one of the reasons why I didn't go in the service, because I didn't get out of high school until the war was over. But in England, they were affected more by it. As Dickie said, they closed down the schools, and they were sent to different families, and it's kind of sad. Stan Kenton has an album out. That's known as a segue in radio. You're talking about one thing, you go to something else. It's connected in a sense, though. Stan Kenton is one of my all-time favorite bands, and was when I was in high school. I couldn't wait to get out of high school to go drum with Stan Kenton's band, and I never did. I've sat in with him once or twice, with Stan, not the band, that is. But Stan has a new album out, and in the album, they are the patriotic themes of nations all around the world. One of the themes happens to be the English national anthem, which is God Save the Queen. It is also sort of a sub-anthem in this country. We know it as My Country 'Tis of Thee. And Stan has a version of it now, and in connection with Dickie being English, and that's the connection all the way around. It's reaching into left field, but I do want to play it for you because it's a fantastic arrangement by Stan Kenton and an album that's not going to be available to December, but we want to thank Stan for giving it. And I'm happy to be able to bring it to you, by the way.
I know that you're happy that I'm happy that you're happy, and I'm sure that our listeners are happy that you're happy that I'm happy.
Honey.
And I'm also sure that you're happy that they're happy that I'm happy that you're happy, and we're both happy that they're happy. And if they're happy,
they're happy.
Then they're happy.
Yes, of course. Now, Stan Kenton and My Country 'Tis of Thee. I don't know about you, but that fascinates me. It's fantastic. Stan Kenton and the band, and from an album, as I mentioned, that won't be out until around December, In My Country 'Tis of Thee, and it's National Anthems of the World.